Light gets reflected when it passes from one medium to another medium with different refractive index. We will use PHET simulation to help us understand this. Torch is our light source. It is placed in air. As light travels from air to water, most of the light gets refracted while some of the light gets reflected. We can find out the percentage of reflection with this meter. 5% of light is reflected back while 95% of it is refracted. As we change the angle of incidence for light, amount of light reflected changes. At low angles, almost half of the light is reflected back in the air. Observe the amount of reflection as we change mediums. If torch is kept in water and another medium is air, light behaves differently at certain angle. 100% of light is reflected back into the water. This is known as total internal reflection. From this simulation, we learned that some light is reflected when it encounters medium with different refractive index. In scientific language, a surface which reflects light and creates clear image is called a mirror. A mirror is a reflecting surface. Historically, mirrors were simply flat pieces of polished copper, brass, or a precious metal. We can also polish a metal to get similar surface. Let's do an activity. We need polished surfaces for reflecting light. This is because polished surfaces absorb less light and so maximum light gets reflected. A stainless steel metal strip is taken and polished with sandpaper. At each step, finer sandpaper is used. This is continued until its surface becomes very smooth and starts reflecting. After each step, the sandpaper removes the scratches from the previous step. We can create reflecting surface with metal as well with this activity. Regular plane mirror is made with glass and highly reflecting and polished coating of silver or aluminium in a process called silvering. Let's do another activity. A mirror reflects everything in front of it, including another mirror. When two mirrors are placed at an angle, the number of reflected images you can see goes up. Let's explore what happens when we use two mirrors instead of one to view the object. Two mirrors are connected together with tape and placed on the table. We will place letter R in between the mirrors. Letter R is not symmetric in horizontal or vertical direction. This will help in knowing the image orientation as well. When angle between mirrors is 120 degrees, we see two images of letter R. Each mirror yields an image which is at equal distance from a dotted line. When angle is decreased, more reflection will occur and number of images formed will be more. When mirrors are placed at an angle of 90 degrees, the two reflections create third image. The number of images formed when two plane mirrors are placed next to each other, inclined at an angle A, can be found out with the help of this formula. Number of images is equal to 360 upon A minus 1. Can you find out what will be angle between the mirrors if 7 images of the objects are formed? Let's perform another activity. Let's take a rubber or foam piece to understand how light rays are reflected by the curved mirrors. We will use kebab sticks to indicate the light rays of light coming from light source. If we bend the rubber piece inwards, it looks like a concave mirror. Observe how all sticks converge or meet at a point. A concave mirror is also called as a focusing mirror. If we bend the rubber piece outward, it looks like a convex mirror. Sticks are pointing outwards, indicating that convex mirror spreads the rays outward. Parallel incident rays get dispersed after reflecting in this mirror. Convex mirror is also called as dispersing mirror. Mirrors and lenses both have the ability to reflect or refract the light. This property has put mirrors and lenses in use for centuries. Plane mirrors have many uses apart from the obvious one of simply to look in. In periscope, plane mirrors are used to bend light so that image of an object can be brought down to a lower level. It is used for observing enemy movements from trenches without any danger of being seen. Sailors on submarines use periscopes to see things above the water level. With the sun as light source, a mirror can be used to signal by variations in orientation of the mirror. The signal can be used over long distances, possibly up to 60 kilometers on a clear day. Mirrors can also be used for search to attract the attention of search and rescue helicopters. They are also used in kaleidoscopes to see round dangerous bends, in meters as mirror tiles, in a sextant, in an overhead projector, an SLR camera, carving mirrors in microscopes, and as a reflecting number plates, to mention only some. The passenger side mirror on a car is typically a convex mirror. Convex mirrors are preferred in vehicles because they give an upright though diminished image. They provide a wider field of view as they are curved outwards. Convex mirrors are often found in the hallways of various buildings, commonly known as hallway safety mirrors, including hospitals, hotels, schools, stores, and apartment buildings. They are usually mounted on a wall or ceiling where hallways intersect each other or where they make sharp turns. They are useful for people accessing the hallways, especially at locations having blind spots or where visibility may be limited. Convex mirrors are used in some automated teller machines as a simple and handy security feature, allowing the users to see what is happening behind them. Concave mirrors are used in reflecting telescopes. Concave mirrors are also used to provide a magnified image of the face for applying makeup or shaving. In illumination applications, concave mirrors are used to gather light from a small source and direct it outwards in a beam, as in torches, headlamps, and spotlights. They are also used to collect light from a large area and focus it on a small spot, as in concentrated solar power. Some dental mirrors use concave surface to provide a magnified image. Take this challenge. Bottom lid of this round container is painted with some color. The lid has a very small opening, just enough to pass the ball pen refill. Can you find out which color was used to paint the bottom of the container without opening the lid?